Yeah, good shit on whoever's using Dragon's Breath. I like you. You're smart.
So, who remembers the Dragon's Breath, the exotic rocket launcher from year one of Destiny? So, back then, this weapon was pretty bad. The special perk it had to it was the Solar Flare. Now, in year two of Destiny, they did buff it and they gave it a brand new perk. So, they replaced the Solar Flare with a Napalm effect, which is great for ad control. So, I decided to take this weapon into the Wrath of the Machine raid on Heroic difficulty and give it a shot and see if it's useful in any part of the raid. And really, the only part that I find that's really fun and useful to use is during Vossic Phase 2 if you're running in the center point. So, the Dragon's Breath has a perk to it called Surplus. Now, this perk increases the chances of enemies dropping heavy ammunition after they die. Now, if you combine this with the Raid Gauntlets, they also have a perk on it that increase the chance of fallen enemies to drop heavy ammunition. So basically, with those two things combined, you double the chance of enemies dropping heavy ammo. So it's a great way to control the adds if you're running in the center. Now, as for the captains, it's actually a pretty bad choice. So if your teammate does happen to have a Gjallarhorn or even a sword or Nova Bomb or a tether, then that's a great alternative. So pretty much the Dragon's Breath is great for ad control in this center point. Now on left and right, it's not that great because enemies come from different locations and you're going to spend more ammo on different points. Sure, you can actually use it in the center part of the left or right area, but enemies don't always run down there because sometimes they tend to stay at the very back and hide behind boxes, and you're pretty much just wasting your time and ammo. Now, if you time it right, you can actually just use one rocket to take care of the first adds that drop down, and by then, the second group will drop down, and you can kill them with that first rocket that's already been in place for a while. So you don't really have to use rockets that often, but you should get plenty of ammo with those two perks in place that I mentioned earlier. So overall, I did run it through the entire raid, and to save you guys the time, this is pretty much the only part that it's actually really useful. Now you might think, what about the Death Zamboni part on the bridge, you know? What about there? There's a lot of ads running around. It's somewhat okay on that area, but there are better choices. You know, it's better to have a sword to deal with the captains or a Gjallarhorn for long range damage. It's not that great in that part, but you might want to use it if you don't have a sword or Gjallarhorn at hand. Now, ever since year one of Destiny, I've always liked the Dragon's Breath, even though back then it was pretty bad, but in year two it got a little bit better. But ever since then, even after the buff of having that great Napalm effect, it's been somewhat one of those less used exotics. It's very situational on where and when you can use it, especially in raids. Now, I'm not saying this is the best choice for any part of the raid. I'm simply saying this is actually pretty fun to use if you're running the center point for Vossic Phase 2 and Wrath of the Machine raid. So if you want to try something different and you want to volunteer to clear the adds in center point on Vossic Phase 2, then give that a shot. You actually might have a lot of fun with it. And if you combine it with a tether, you can make orbs really quick for your team in the center point. So I did test it out in King's Fall raid about a year ago, and I do have a video, and I'll try to put it at the end of this with an annotation so you guys can check it out. And once again, it was very situational in that raid too, but it was actually fun to use. So that's it for this video. Thanks for watching, guys. Leave a thumbs up, I appreciate it, and subscribe to the channel. And don't forget to click the bell icon and enable notifications so you guys get notified when I upload a video on the channel. I'll catch you guys in the next video. I'm out.